हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस बिगिन चैप्टर 8, विंड्स, स्टॉर्म्स एंड साइक्लोन्स। उड़ीसा वॉज हिट बाय अ साइक्लोन विद विंड स्पीड ऑफ 200 किलोमीटर पर आवर ऑन 18 अक्टूबर 1999। द साइक्लोन स्मैश्ड 45,000 हाउसेस, मेकिंग 7 लाख पीपल होमलेस। ऑन 29 अक्टूबर द सेम ईयर, a second cyclone with wind speed of 260 km per hour hit Orissa again. It was accompanied by water waves about 9 meter high. Thousands of people lost their lives. Property worth crores of rupees was destroyed. The cyclone affected agriculture, transport, communication and electricity supply. But what are cyclones? How are they formed? Why are they so destructive? In this chapter, we shall seek answers to some of these questions. So, in this paragraph, we read about a cyclone that hit Orissa in the year 1999 twice. Pehle 18 October ko aur uske baad 29 October ko, two times a cyclone took place in the state of Orissa. सो ये जो साइक्लोन हुआ उस वजह से काफ़ी लॉस हुआ ह्यूमन लाइफ का और प्रॉपर्टी का। देर वॉज ऑल्सो द साइक्लोन ऑल्सो अफेक्टेड एग्रीकल्चर, ट्रांसपोर्ट, कम्युनिकेशन एंड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सप्लाई। सो वी कैन से दैट साइक्लोन इज़ अ नेचुरल कैलामिटी विच कॉसेस लॉस टू ह्यूमन लाइफ एंड प्रॉपर्टी। हियर यू कैन सी द नंबर्स of people who lost their lives and the numbers of people who lost their property is very high. So what are cyclones? Why do they happen? Why are they so destructive? इन सब चीज़ों के बारे में हम इस चैप्टर में डिस्कस करेंगे कि साइक्लोन्स क्यों होते हैं, वो कैसे फॉर्म होते हैं और वो इतने डिस्ट्रक्टिव क्यों है, यानी कि वो इतने डिस्ट्रक्शन क्यों कॉज करते हैं, इतनी लॉस क्यों कॉज करते हैं। So, we will be seeking answers, we will find answers to these questions in this chapter. We begin with some activities involving air. These activities will clarify some basic features concerning a cyclone. Before we begin, remember that the moving air is called the wind. So, next we are going to perform some activities which involve air. और इन activities से हमें clarify हो जाएगा, यानी कि clear हो जाएगा कुछ ऐसे basic features जो cyclones से related है, that are related to cyclones. So, before we begin, we should remember the meaning of wind. The moving air is called the wind. When air moves, we call it wind. Let us discuss the next topic. Air exerts pressure. Activity 8.1. Whenever an activity involves heating, be very careful. It is advised that such activities are performed in presence of an elderly person from your family, or carry out these activities in the presence of your teacher. So the activities we are going to perform next involve heating. That means you have to come in contact with the flame. So you should be very careful when you handle flame, because if you are not careful, then there is a chance of you getting burned because of that. So whenever you are performing any activity, any experiment which involves heating or flame or hot objects, you should have an elderly person with you, or you should perform that in presence of a teacher. So let us now begin activity 8.1. You need to boil water in the following activity. Take a tin can with a lid. Fill it approximately half with water. Heat the can on a candle flame till the water boils. Let the water boil for a few minutes. Blow out the candle. Immediately put the lid tightly on the can. Be careful in handling the hot can. Put the can carefully in a shallow metallic vessel or a wash basin. Pour fresh water over the can. What happens to the shape of the can? In this activity, you require a tin can. In this, you have to fill some water and boil the water by placing the can on top of a candle flame as shown in figure 8.2. Now, you do not actually have to perform this activity. I will tell you the observations and conclusions of this activity. We will just understand this activity carefully. So, once the water starts boiling, blow out the candle and immediately put the lid tightly on the can. Precaution must be followed before doing so. After that, put the can carefully in the wash basin and pour fresh water, that is cold water, on top of the can and observe. It can be observed that the can gets crushed and its shape gets distorted, just like it is shown in figure. When the water is poured, the can gets crushed aur uska jo shape hai wo badal jata hai. Why does this happen? What is the reason for this? On pouring cold water over the can, the water vapor inside the can gets cooled and gets converted into water. As we know, water vapor when cooled gets converted into water. This water occupies less space than the water vapor. So the air pressure inside decreases. Air pressure outside the can is more than the pressure inside. That is why the can gets crushed. So from this activity, we can conclude that air exerts pressure. If you cannot get a tin can, take a soft plastic bottle, fill it with hot water, empty the bottle and immediately cap it tightly. Place the bottle under running water. Now this activity you can perform. For this you have to take a plastic bottle and usme aapko hot water fill karna hai. Water which is already hot wo aapko fill karna hai. So isme aapko flame use karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Jo hot water available hai wo water aapko is bottle mein fill karna hai aur uske baad aapko wo bottle ko empty karna hai and then immediately you have to put on the cap of the bottle. Tightly you have to close it and then you have to place the bottle under running water. In this case also you can observe that the shape of the plastic bottle, which is soft, the shape of the soft plastic bottle changes, that is it gets distorted. This is also because of the air pressure inside and outside the bottle. Recall now some of your experiences. When you fly a kite, does the wind coming from your back help? If you are in a boat, is it easier to row it if there is wind coming from behind you? Do you find it difficult to ride a bicycle against the direction of the wind? You know that we have to fill air into the bicycle tube to keep it tight. Also, do you know that a bicycle tube overfilled with air may burst? What is the air doing inside the tube? Discuss with your friends how the air in the bicycle tube keeps it in shape. When you are flying a kite, the direction of the wind is a thing that you keep in mind because it helps your kite to fly. If you have ever been in a boat, you must know that it is easier to row the boat in the direction in which the wind is coming. That is, if you are moving in the same direction as the wind, then it is easy to row the boat. But if you are going against the direction of the wind, like if you are riding a bicycle, then you might find it difficult to pedal the bicycle because the direction of the wind is opposing you. You might know that a bicycle tire is filled with air to keep it tight. And what happens if the air is overfilled? Then the tire bursts. Why does this happen? All these happen because of air pressure. All these experiences show that the air exerts pressure. It is due to this pressure that the leaves of trees, banners or flag flutter when the wind is blowing. You can list some more experiences which show that the air has pressure. So as I told you, all these happen because of the pressure of air. The leaves of the trees or banners or flags flutter when the wind is blowing because of the pressure that air exerts. There are many more examples which show you that air has pressure, just like in activity 8.1, as the can or the plastic bottle gets crushed, we can conclude that air exerts pressure. Let us now try to explain why the can or the bottle gets distorted. As the water is poured over the can, some steam in the can condenses into water, reducing the amount of air inside. The pressure of air inside the can decreases than the pressure exerted by the air from outside the can. As a result, the can gets compressed. This activity again confirms that air exerts pressure. Now, just like we saw in activity, here we have the explanation of it, that when water is poured over the can, जो steam है can के अंदर, because can के अंदर गर्म पानी था, तो there is steam inside the can. So, this steam, when cooled, gets condensed into water. This reduces the amount of air inside the can. The air pressure inside the can decreases, then the pressure outside the can, that is the pressure exerted by the air which is outside the can, increases. So, because of this, the can gets crushed. So, from this activity, we can confirm that air exerts pressure.